When you say Afghanistan, first thing that comes to your mind is probably a war, and it's not unusual at all. In this video, we are talking about Afghan war. Talibans are a political and a religious faction that emerged in Afghanistan in the mid-90s, following the withdrawal of Soviet troops. The collapse of Afghanistan's communist regime and the subsequent breakdown in civil order, the faction took its time. From its membership, which consisted largely of students trained in Islamic religious schools that had been established for Afghan refugees in the 1980s in northern Pakistan. Now, let's talk a bit more about Soviets. In 1979, a year after OCCAP, the Soviet army invaded Afghanistan to support its communist government. It fought a resistance movement known as Mujahideen that was supported by the US, Pakistan, China and Saudi Arabia, among other countries. In 1989, Soviet troops withdrew, but the civil war continued. In the chaos that followed, the Taliban, which means students in Pashto language, sprang up. In 1996, the Taliban seized Kabul and instituted a severe interpretation of Islamic law that, for example, forbid female education and prescribed the severing of hands or even execution as punishment for petty crimes. That same year, Al-Qaeda leader Osama bin Laden was welcomed to Afghanistan, having been expelled from Sudan, and established his organization's headquarters there. With Al-Qaeda's help, the Taliban won control of over 19% of Afghan territory by the summer of 2001. On September 11, 2001, attacks in America killed nearly 3,000 people. Osama bin Laden, the head of Islamist terror group Al-Qaeda, was quickly identified as the man responsible. The Taliban, radical Islamists who run Afghanistan and protected bin Laden, refused to hand him over. We did not ask for this mission, but we will fulfill it, US President George Bush said when he announced the first air strike against Afghanistan on 7 October 2001. The raids were in the response to the 9/11 attacks, which killed 2,977 people in New York, Washington and Pennsylvania. There are many reasons for this, but they include a combination of Taliban resistance and the limitation of Afghan forces and governments and other countries to keep their troops for longer in Afghanistan. At times over the past 18 years, the Taliban have been on the back foot. In late 2009, US President Barack Obama announced a troop surge that saw the number of American soldiers in Afghanistan top 100,000. The surge helped drive the Taliban out of parts of southern Afghanistan, but it was never destined to last for years. As a result, the Taliban were able to regroup when international forces withdrew from fighting. Afghan forces left to lead the charge were easily overwhelmed. To make matters worse, Afghanistan's government, that is full of tribal division, is often hamstrung. The group could be making as much as $1.5 billion a year, a huge increase even within the past decade. Some of this is through drugs. Afghanistan is the world's largest opium producer, and most opium puppies used for heroin are grown in Taliban-held areas. But the Taliban also make money by taxing people who travel through their territory, and through the businesses like telecommunications, electricity and minerals. Foreign countries, including Pakistan and Iran, have denied founding them, but private citizens from the Rudet region are thought to have done so. It's difficult to say how many Afghan troops have died so far. But in January 2019, Afghan president said 45,000 members of the security forces had been killed since 2014. Nearly 3,500 members of the international forces had died since 2001 invasion. More than 2,300 of them are American. The figures for Afghan civilians are more difficult to quantify. A UN report in February 2019 said more than 32,000 civilians had died. The Vaston Institute at Brown University says 42,000. The same institute says conflicts in Iraq, Syria, Afghanistan and Pakistan have cost US $5.9 trillion since 2001. The US is still conducting airstrikes against Taliban by the third president to oversee the war, Donald Trump. But he is keen to reduce troops numbers before he faces another elections in November 2020. The Taliban now control much more territory than they did when international troops left Afghanistan in 2014. Many in Washington and elsewhere fear that a full US troop pullout would leave a vacuum that could be filled by militant groups seeking to plot attacks in the West. The Afghan people, meanwhile, continue to be near the brunt of the long and bloody conflict. What do you think? Will this stop or will it burst even more? Leave your answer in the comments below. You are watching Force Troop, and if you like this video, consider subscribing, leave a like and drop a comment. And until next video, goodbye.